What if you are not a licensed nurse? Meron bang pag-asang makapunta dito sa Canada or hindi man ba ang trabaho ng mga not licensed nurses dito sa Canada? That's our today's discussion. If you're ready, let's begin mga kap! And what's up mga kap, and welcome to our When in Halifax Cup Unity. Ayan mga kap, kumusta po kayo? So in this video, we will answer one of the questions natin dito sa ating YouTube comments, si Your Life Companion. Sabi ni Your Life Companion, what if nga ba hindi ka licensed sa Pilipinas, hindi man ba dito sa Canada? On this topic mga kap, I want you to remember two things. Number one, you have hope or meron kang pag-asa. Pero case to case basis, it depends on your situation mga kap. And I'm going to discuss this, I'm going to answer this question through a scenario. Sabi ko nga, case to case basis ang sagot ko dito. So, number one, case number one or scenario number one is, you are a BSN graduate. Tapos ka ng BSN and at the same time, nakapagtrabaho ka as a caregiver sa abroad. Sa Dubai, Hong Kong, or saan naman. BSN, nakapagtrabaho ng caregiver. BSN, walang license, pero ang trabaho is call center. So this is the two scenario that I want to present. So the first scenario mga kap is BSN graduate, nakapagtrabaho, nakapag-abroad, or nakapagtrabaho, merong experience sa caregiver. Now my answer is yes, you have the chance and in demand ang trabaho mo. Ano yun? Caregiver pathway. Sa caregiver mga kap, always remember there's two things that you need to remember in a caregiver. Number one is you need to have a caregiver experience. That's the number one. Number two is hindi kailangan that you are a licensed RN. Sa caregiver pathway, ang kailangan lang is Canadian High School Equivalent. Canadian High School Equivalent. So since you are a BSN, ibig sabihin bachelor graduate ka ng nursing, ibig sabihin kapag pinaraces mo ito sa ECA or Education Credential Assessment, ito ay nag-equivalent ng maybe second year to third year bachelor's degree graduate. So, ibig sabihin, pasok na pasok ka sa caregiver pathway. That's the number one. So, meron kang experience, meron kang education, then you are eligible for caregiver. So, if you are not a licensed RN, hindi ka RN sa Pilipinas, pero meron kang caregiver experience, then try to explore the caregiver pathway. Pero you need to have what? Experience. The second scenario is you are a BSN graduate, pero you are working as a call center. Sabihin natin, napakalayo sa healthcare related. Hindi related sa nursing ang trabaho mo. So you work, sabihin natin, call center. So pasok ba sa caregiver? The answer is no. Hindi pasok ang iyong experience sa caregiver. Even though you are a BSN graduate, pero yung work experience mo ay hindi pasok sa caregiver pathway. Because it's very clear mga kap, sa caregiver pathway, kailangan po na meron kang experience as a caregiver. So that's my answer to your question, Your Life Companion. So it's a case-to-case basis. So if you are BSN, hindi ka licensed, at yung experience mo ay napakalayo sa healthcare, wala sa caregiver, then hindi ka po makakapag-apply sa caregiver pathway. If you have an education, so pwedeng BSN yan, pwedeng teacher yan, basta meron kang caregiver experience sa abroad or sa Pilipinas na paid experience at least 1 to 2 years, then pasok ka sa caregiver pathway. So that's my answer to you, Your Life Companion. And another bonus tip that I want you to remember mga kap, if you are a BSN mga kap and you are planning to immigrate dito sa Canada and later part you want to be an RN dito sa Canada, my suggestion to you is take the board exam. take the board exam, get your registration mo mga kap, because you will have advantage if you're planning to be an RN dito sa Canada. So always remember mga kap, you need to be an RN para po ma-pursue mo or ma-push mo yung career mo as an RN. Always remember mga kap, if you have the chance to be an RN, take it mga kap. Take the exam, be an RN. Bakit naman kap? This is, I'll just give you a visual. Number one, para po maging RN dito sa Canada, you need to be evaluated by the NNAS or EDNAS. Itong EDNAS na to ay ini-evaluate ang ating experience, work experience. Ini-evaluate ito ang ating registration as an RN, yung PRC natin. Ini-evaluate din natin, ini-evaluate yung education natin and ang ating language test. So, ang tanong ko sa iyo mga kap, if they will evaluate your work experience, if you are not an RN, hindi ka po RN, wala kang experience. So, mababa na ang resulta mo kasi wala kang experience. And sabi ng EDNAS, i-evaluate yung registration mo, eh hindi ka registered nurse. So, mababa na yung result mo kasi hindi ka registered RN. So, for me mga kap, if you are planning to be an RN dito sa Canada, you want to practice as an RN dito sa Canada, my advice for you is take the exam, pass the exam, because once you pass the exam, you can work as a nurse sa Pilipinas and you can gain experience. Then kapag meron kang experience, mas tumataas yung evaluation mo sa EDNAS. So mas lumilinaw, mas mapapadali ang iyong pangarap na maging RN dito sa Canada. So that's my answer for you, your life companion, and I hope you find it helpful. If you find it helpful, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and see you in our next video. See you mga kap. Bye!